This video about whole numbers is looking at mental strategies. A really important mental strategy when we're looking at whole numbers is that often we can make easy numbers by rearranging. So sometimes it's possible to rearrange a calculation to make it easier. Theoretical laws make this possible, but you can still use the strategies without knowing the names of the laws as long as you use them properly. The commutative law only applies to addition and multiplication, so you can't use it for subtraction or for division or for any other operation, but go nuts for addition and multiplication. And what the commutative law says is that the order that two numbers are added or multiplied doesn't change the answer. So for example, if we look at 3 plus 4 equals 7, if we start at 3 and then add 4, so we go 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, we get to 7. If we look the other order and we start at 4 and then we add 3, so we go 4, 5, 6, 7, we still get to 7. Now this is grade 1 maths, you've done this before, but this is what the law is called that says that it's mathematically doable to do this for addition, that it doesn't matter what order you do it in, that 3 plus 4 is the same as 4 plus 3. It also applies to multiplication. So if you've got two groups of five, you've got 10. And if you've got five groups of two, you've got 10. So it doesn't matter what order you do your timesing in either. The associative law is similar. And again, it only applies to addition and multiplication. The associative law says that the order that three or more numbers are grouped and then added or multiplied, depending on what you're asked to do, doesn't change the answer. So to look at some examples, here I've got three numbers. I've got 2 times 3 times 5. So it doesn't matter whether I do, as I'm writing here, if I do the 2 times 3 first, or if I do the 3 times 5 first, it doesn't matter. If I do the 2 times 3 first, I'll end up with 6, and then I still need to deal with the times 5. If I do the 3 times 5 first, then I'll get to 15, and then I need to deal with the times 2. If I then do 6 times 5, I'll get to 30, and if I do 2 times 15, I'll get to 30. So it didn't matter which order we did those in, we still got to 30. It doesn't matter which order you group the numbers in if there's three or more. We see the same thing for addition. So 1 plus 2 plus 3. If I do 1 plus 2 first, I'll get to 3. If I do the 2 plus 3 first, I'll get to 5. So then if I do 3 plus 3, I'll get to 6. And this, I'll get the same answer. If I do 1 plus 5, I'll then get to 6. So the associative law says that the order that three or more numbers are grouped and then added or multiplied doesn't change the answer. So you can group them in the order that makes it easiest for you to do that sum. Now we're going to have a look at some examples.
Calculate the following by rearranging them into easier combinations. So when we look at example one here, we've got 2 times 14 times 5. Now when I look at that, some easy numbers to multiply together are going to be 2 and 5 because they'll multiply together to give me 10, which is then a nice number to multiply further from. So I'm going to rearrange that so that I get 2 times 5 times 14. I can then do 2 times 5 will be 10. And then I still need to times that by 14. And then if I do 10 times 14, that will give me 140. Now, if I stop to check that on my calculator, I'll get 2 times 14 times 5. That gives me 140, which is what I got there. So my answer is valid. For the next example, I've got 292 plus 429. Now, when I look at these numbers, 292 is almost 300. So if I take a little bit off this number to bring that number up to 300, I'll then have 300 plus something, which is an easier sum to do. So to go from 292 up to 300, I'm going to need to split 8 off this number. So I'll have 292. If I split 8 off 429, then I'll get 8 plus 421. I can then do this part of the sum. So I'll get 292 plus 8 is 300. And then I've got plus 421 left over to deal with. So 300 plus 421 is going to be easy, because 421 plus 300 will bring it up to 721. I don't need to worry about changing those last two because I've got zeros there. Again, if I then check that on my calculator, 292 plus 429 gives me 721, which is the answer that I got. So that's correct.
The distributive law says that you can split the multiplication of numbers up into smaller parts, and then you can add them together. So to have a look at an example, if I asked you to do 14 times 5, now I never learnt my 14 times tables off by rote, but what I did learn is my 10 times tables and my 4 times tables. So I know that 14 is 10 plus 4. So I can split that 14 into 10 and 4, and then I can work out the 5 times tables for that and then add it back together again. So I know that 10 times 5 is 50 and 4 times 5 is 20. So if I then add 50 plus 20, I'll end up with 70. And 70 is actually what, if you put 14 times 5 into your calculator, you will get 70. But this is a way of rearranging a sum, or in this case, it's a calculation that involves multiplication. You can split the multiplication up into two easier ones and then add them back together. So the distributive law says that we're allowed to do that, and we'll end up with the correct answer. Now we're going to have a look at some more examples.
Evaluate the following by rearranging using the distributive law. So the calculation that I've got here is 8 times 34. Now, I don't know my 34 times tables, but what I can do is split 34 up into things that are easier. So I can split 34 up into 30 plus 4, and then that's numbers that are easier to work with. So that will give me 8 times 30 plus 4. And we're allowed to do that under the rules of the distributive law. So what we can then expand that out, we'll then get 8 times 30. And we then need to do plus 8 times 4. And what we now have is two multiplications that are easier to do than the original one that we had. So when I do 8 times 30, I can just do that as 8 times 3, which is 24. And then I need to also multiply that by 10 because it's 30, not 3. So that gives me 240. And then, oops, sorry, that should be times. And then 8 times 4 is 32. So I then need to add those back together the same way that I split them up here. So if I've got 240 plus 32, then that will give me 272 as my answer. Again, if I check that on my calculator, if I've got 8 times 34, then that will give me 272, which is what we got. So that's the correct answer.
In summary, you can use these laws to rearrange calculations into easier combinations to work out. The commutative law and the associative law only apply to addition and multiplication. You cannot use them for subtraction or division or any other operation. The distributive law only applies to multiplication. You don't need to worry so much about the names of the laws as long as you're using their properties correctly when you apply your mental strategies.